In this video, I'm going back to the basics of the foundation of what is cryptocurrency, what is blockchain, and basically what is Web3 in general, because it's a massive structure on its own. That's what we'll talk about, so let's get right into it. A quick disclaimer, I'm not a financial advisor. All right, now let's get right into this video. But before we start, I do want to say that we'll be covering multiple concepts. They might be a little bit difficult at first, but I'll make sure to explain them thoroughly so you can understand them at the end of this video. If you still want to look back at some of the content we'll talk about, then you have to know that all the links for the content of this video will be down in the description. So now let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing we're going to be talking about, the first concept, and also I think the most interesting concept, is cryptocurrencies. What are cryptocurrencies? You hear it everywhere. Cryptocurrency. What is it? What should you know about it? Well, generally, a cryptocurrency is a digital or virtual currency, like a dollar, but then virtual, secured by cryptography. That's also where the name comes from. And this makes it nearly impossible to counterfeit or double spend if the code behind a cryptocurrency is well written. But that's a little bit too difficult. We will not go into depth about that. So many cryptocurrencies are also decentralized networks on blockchain technology. So we kind of use network and blockchain interchangeably in crypto. And this is basically a distributed ledger or a database enforced by a network of computers all over the world. So for example, you have Bitcoin. Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency, and Bitcoin also has a network or a blockchain which stores all of these Bitcoins. And the same goes for Ethereum. But apart from that, you also have other cryptocurrencies that do not have their own blockchain, but are issued on a different blockchain. So you can also have, for example, a different cryptocurrency token on the Ethereum blockchain. Now, a defining feature usually of cryptocurrencies is that they are generally not issued by any central authority, rendering them theoretically immune to government interference or manipulation. Usually when explaining cryptocurrency, I also think that this graph or this figure is quite interesting and quite helpful. So basically, how to summarize it is that a cryptocurrency is digital money created from code. So a developer has coded a code base for a cryptocurrency, and that's really the basis. Then the cryptocurrency economy is monitored by a peer-to-peer internet protocol. So basically, peer-to-peer, computer-to-computer, person-to-person secures it. And a cryptocurrency is an encrypted string or data of a hash encoded to signify one unit of a currency. So some big examples are Bitcoin, Ethereum, or XRP. So now that we have talked about cryptocurrencies, we also need to talk about blockchains a little bit more. So to give you a brief introduction on blockchains, a blockchain is basically a distributed database or ledger shared among computer networks nodes. So basically, computers all over the world share this distributed ledger or database. And as a database, a blockchain stores information electronically in a digital format. And blockchains are best known for their crucial role in cryptocurrency systems, such as Bitcoin, for maintaining a secure and decentralized record of transactions. That's mainly what a blockchain is, at least in the case of Bitcoin. In the case of, for example, Ethereum, it also stores other data, but perhaps that's a little bit too difficult to get into already right now. So let's talk a little bit about how a blockchain actually works. So the goal of a blockchain is to allow digital information to be recorded and distributed, but not edited. That really is a key thing of a blockchain. So in this way, the blockchain is the foundation for immutable ledgers or records of transactions that cannot be altered, deleted, or destroyed. And this is also, and you will see this abbreviation more often while researching crypto, this is also why blockchains are sometimes named DLTs, or distributed ledger technology. So how the blockchain usually works, so for example with Bitcoin, we'll use Bitcoin as an example, is like this. You have a new transaction, I send one Bitcoin to you. The transaction is then transmitted to a network of peer-to-peer computers scattered over the world, and all of these computers of all over the world are called nodes, and they go over the transaction and they all try to battle for the transaction. And then one computer gets the transaction while agreeing with all of the other computers in the network that the transaction is valid. The computer has solved an equation, that's why it has won. And then once they actually have confirmed the transaction, they put it into a block. And this block at the end is validated and added to the blockchain, which basically means that in the end you have a chain of different blocks, and those blocks consist of different data or transactions, and then you get a big network or a database of blocks that consists of transactions. Now, a blockchain is obviously invented because it has several benefits, and I wanted to talk about that briefly because I think it's important to know some of those benefits. So the first one is the accuracy of the chain. So transactions on the blockchain network are approved by a network of thousands of computers or nodes, or miners. They're all the same thing. And this removes almost all human involvement in the verification process, resulting in less human error and an accurate record of information. So basically, with a blockchain, you don't have to rely on humans putting in the right data. No, the blockchain actually is efficient and it's smart. The data is correct. Apart from that, blockchains often also reduce costs. So typically, consumers pay a bank to verify a transaction, a notary to sign a document, or a minister to perform a marriage. But in a blockchain, this can all be just stored on the blockchain, automatically using computers and using smart contracts. So for example, right now, if you want to send someone on the other side of the world money via a bank, you pay almost all of the money you want to send to actually send the transaction through. With a blockchain, it doesn't matter where the people are. It's secured globally, and you don't have to pay extra if you want to send it to someone next door or on the other side of the world. And apart from that, and that's maybe the biggest benefit, is that it's decentralized. A blockchain does not store any of its information in a central location. Instead, as we talked about earlier as well, the blockchain is copied and spread across a network of computers or nodes or miners all over the world. All right, so with that, we have reached the end of this video. Again, all the links you will need will be down in the description. But if you found this video helpful, please make sure to add a like and add comments with questions I might have missed. And subscribe to our channel.